In this mini video lecture, I am going to talk about the read-only memory. So far, I have talked about the main memory or the RAM, and I am going to talk about the hard disk or the secondary memory, which also includes devices like DVDs, pen drives, and so on. Now, you must be wondering, why would we require a memory which is read-only memory? For a detailed understanding of that, you will have to wait till a few more videos to understand why do we use ROM in computers, because when I am going to discuss about the computer booting or the starting process, what all happens when you just switch on the power supply and press the on button, that's when you'll understand the value and the importance of ROM. Now, ROM or read-only memory is used to store data or code of a permanent nature. So if a program is written into a memory which is not modifiable, that particular piece of software is called as the firmware. So firmware is a software which is of a permanent nature, programmed or written onto a read-only memory. Now, I had already told you, to get a detailed understanding of the ROM and its usage, you will know about its utility when we are discussing the computer booting process. But still, I'll try to make it as clear as possible through a small example right now. Let us say I have an office of say 20 rooms, and I have in each of the 20 rooms five people working. So what I do is, I have a smart camera or a sensor. That sensor detects whether there are people in that room or not. Whenever there are people in that room, it automatically says switches on the power supply, that is the bulbs, and as well as the air conditioner. When nobody is there, it doesn't make sense to leave the power supply and the air conditioner on. That's when it should switch it off. So what I do is, I take a read-only memory and program it just once, so that whenever it sees people, it switches on the light bulb and the air conditioner, and whenever it doesn't see anybody, it just automatically switches off. Now, why do I write the program in the ROM? Because my requirement is never going to change. It is a fixed requirement where the only job my small computer is doing is switching on the power supply on and off. So this is an example where you will use a read-only memory. Now, although what I am saying is not 100% correct right now, but it's good to know it. Non-volatile is a major property of ROM. That means the contents of the ROM are not lost when power is switched off. Okay? Here, instructions and data of a permanent nature are generally stored in a ROM. So, programs and data which are required for a very long time are kept in a ROM. Now, a very nice example of where you could use ROMs could be in your washing machine, your mobile phones and cameras. Let me talk about your washing machine or dishwasher. If you have looked at a modern washing machine, say for a company like Bosch or any of these companies like that, IFB in India, you will notice that washing is a fixed process. It doesn't change every day. You just got certain settings, you adjust the settings, just press the on button, and there is an automatic computer which will control how the washing happens based on the settings you have given. So here the instructions are fixed. Okay, so that is why what you will do is, you will use ROM to program instructions for the washing machine or the dishwasher. Alright, that is the example of usage of a ROM. So in a subsequent video, I will talk about the role of the ROM in the booting process of a computer. Now, initially I had told you ROM means read-only memory, but that is not 100% correct, because nowadays you have ROMs where you can change the content or you can reprogram it based on your requirement. So now what I'll be doing is, I'll be discussing the different types of ROM. The first type of ROM is the MROM, also known as the masked read-only memory. So here what happens is, once it is produced in the factory, okay, the code and data is written into that particular read-only memory and you are not able to change it. So it allows you to write only once. You cannot change it. Hardwired means it is fixed. It is non-changeable. All right. Now let's look at the second type of ROM. The second type of ROM is PROM. This stands for Programmable Read-Only Memory. In this type of memory, suppose you get a ROM chip. It is a blank chip. That blank chip, you can modify it or program it once. The programming is done using electrical or ultraviolet signals. Let us say, for example, you got a camera. Okay. Now, if you look at the cameras, the modern cameras are highly sophisticated and they allow you to do certain programming. So what you decide to do is you want to do certain settings permanently for your use. Just giving you an example, may not really be like this, but it may be different, but just to give you an idea. So what you do is, using a particular set of keys, you do some instructions, and using electric signals, it can automatically program the read-only memory to function as per your requirements. It needs to be understood that it can be programmed only once and never erased after that. So that's why it is called programmable read-only memory. Now I'm going to talk about another class of memories called as memories which can be programmed multiple times. So the first of that type is called as the EEPROM. Okay, EEPROM stands for Erasable and Programmable Read-Only Memory. Now such a memory can be erased using ultraviolet light. That means the contents of that memory can be changed, the data or the instructions. See, basically what is 1 and 0? Presence of light may indicate 1, presence of no light may indicate 0. So maybe using ultraviolet light, we can change the content of that particular thing. Now, let me talk about the last type of memory I am really interested in. Although there are many types of ROMs, I'm just going to talk the last one. We have something called as the EEEPROM. This stands for Electrically Erasable and Programmable Read-Only Memory. In this type of memory, this read-only memory can be programmed and erased electrically almost any number of times you wish. So this can be a very good example of using in your digital camera or your smartphone. Say for example, in your digital camera, you want to change the behavior of your camera every week with some new settings and you want to remember and not keep doing that settings again. Maybe you will use a EEPROM. Generally, it allows you to program and change the contents of the memory about 10,000 or more number of times. The advantage of EEPROMs is you can change just a small location or a small portion of the data without having to change the content of the entire chip. That means it allows you to modify even a very small area. 8 bits is called as 1 byte at a time. Let me tell you a little more about differences between a ROM and RAM as well as the similarity. ROM is also a random access memory. That means you can randomly read at a selected location from the ROM. But it is much slower than the RAM, much cheaper than the RAM, okay? And its size is very, very less compared to a RAM. If the RAM is say 8 GB, 16 GB, you may have the ROM maybe of just 512 kilobytes, okay? Maybe even 32 kilobytes and so on. Now, I'll just give you an idea how this masked ROM is being able to program only once. If you have seen the fuse of your house, if the fuse is cut off, what happens? The power supply does not work. So what the computer does is, or what the ROM programmer really does is, you can think of ROM data storage like this. Okay, you can think of ROM data storage like this. That means each of this particular locations, these all of these can store a data 1 or 0 bit. So what I am going to do in this, suppose I want to make something 0, okay, I will blow out the fuse. That means I will remove the fuse. Suppose I want to make this particular 1, then I will keep the fuse as it is. So this way, using the concept of a fuse, I am able to program a ROM That is programmable read-only memory once by blowing off the fuse or putting on the fuse to represent 0 and 1 respectively. So using the concept of a fuse, I am able to represent 0 or 1. That is the working of this programmable read-only memory. So this prompts generally use very, very small fuse, okay, invisible size almost. Fuses to represent zeros and ones. Now, if you looked at EEPROMs and EEPROMs, they don't use the fuse, they use the transistors. Now, since a transistor is nothing but a switch, so through electric signals and light, I can make this switch on and off. So, if I put, say, for example, an electrical signal or an ultraviolet light on a transistor, okay, by switching on the current, I can make it one. By doing again some different current, I can make it zero. So this way, what I can do is I can switch on and off the transistor multiple times. But with the fuse, once you remove the blow out the fuse, it cannot be brought back. That's why in a PROM you use the fuse logic, whereas in the EEPROMs and EEPROMs you use the transistor to achieve the programming by being able to store ones and zeros, because the transistor through some electrical and ultraviolet signals can be made one and zero. That's the reason how you can program these two fellows. So I hope this gives you an idea about what is a read-only memory. In the next session, maybe in 2 or 3 video lectures, possibly in the next week, when I'm talking about when you start or boot up the computer, you will really understand the importance of the read-only memory. For now, this should be more than adequate.